On the riverside in the heart of Lewis, sculptor Nick Johnson lives with his family. His passion for the natural beauty of wood has not only inspired his remarkable sculptures, but has also influenced his choice of home.
I think what attracted us was the functional quality of the building. It was just a great big block and wooden framed. I love wood very much. We could impose ourselves on it, our own thoughts, our own ideas on it, bring out its real qualities. Well, I know this building's been here since at least 1840, and probably before. They exported grain from here to Ireland, which is pretty extraordinary when you see how narrow and shallow the river is now. When I start work, it's with a stack of old wood. I particularly like old wood. It's wonderful grain, it's dry, it's mature. I draw out the flat shape. On goes another layer of wood, another, getting fatter, 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 a bit like a sliced loaf, actually, like that. I screw it through, I dowel it through, I put bolts through it. Out comes a chisel, and I refine the shape. As I'm working, the nails and the pegs and the bits of metal which have held the work originally together are exposed, almost like geological layers that have been, you know, almost like sort of glaciation. You're rediscovering screws and nails you put weeks or months before. Charlie is our family dog, our family pet, and he's always there. I'm hopefully familiar with his physique, which I think is fantastic. I mean, he's a walking anatomy lesson, really. And I've already done him several times, but I hope to do him several times more. He's just a wonderful model. I find him extremely beautiful, even though I've had him for 8 years and familiarity should breed contempt, but I still think he's a great model. Nick trained as an artist in both Brighton and London. Now selling his sculptures through prestigious London galleries, he continues to work exclusively from his home on a variety of animals made entirely from found and reclaimed wood. I find most of my timber in skips. I just go wandering around and I fish it out. And demolition sites. It often happens, I come down in the morning, there's a nice little stack of timber, and someone's left it for me. And I think people quite like their rubbish to be reused. I think it amuses them. It might be turned into, I mean, the bed that they pulled apart could be turned into, I don't know, a hare or a sheep or something. I think it amuses them. I quite like the idea of something wild or natural, which is timber, being very exposed and then polished. So it's both very civilized, very refined, and very natural. I like that opposite. I like experimenting with stains and the flamingo, that was Carthamus pink. It's a kind of a gouache, actually. I slung that all over it. I do have an affection for Africa, but I don't think that my work has much connection with African art. It's just that the sculpture is wonderful and inspirational in its own terms and gives me fantastic pleasure.
Most of Nick's sculptures are bought by people for their homes. Not many, however, would have room for some of his larger work, like this life-size zebra, inspired by his trips to Africa.
When we went to Kenya about 9 or 10 years ago, we saw huge herds of zebras I thought it was interesting. It's different from a horse. I mean, a horse has been done so many times. Somehow, to do a horse is obligatory. Why not do it in a different way? To do a zebra, it's just different. And then you've got this interesting problem of the stripes. It's not a problem, it's a challenge. So, I mean, my sculptures are obviously striped one way with a layer upon layer of wood, and yet I have to stripe it the other way. And I thought it would be an interesting contrast to have two sets of stripes. I have upstairs an ancient zebra skin, and I copied it onto the zebra. I sketched it out and drew it on and stained it in. I work on several pieces at once. I probably worked on it over a year, but with other things going on as well. But I can't remember exactly. Maybe I don't care to remember. It's such a long time. It's quite depressing when I think about it. I can only think in terms of the next piece, really. I want to do a camel. A cheetah I want to do. No, I can't see any great ultimate. I just want to do as many as I possibly can.
Nick Johnson is a...